Bueno, nos encontramos con el señor director de la película Aviones, Planes. Hola, Clay.
Hola, hola.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm fine. It's a funny movie, it's great, there is action, there is, like, the poster, A World Above Cars.
Right.
Tell me, how did it all begin? Why you decided to do the movie based on planes, but with the same feeling as cars?
Yeah, it's a good question. You know, John Lasseter and I, we've become good friends. We're both geeks about airplanes, cars, trains, all kinds of machines. And one day he was flying down from Pixar and he had this epiphany. He was aware that I had a background in aviation. Mm-hmm. My dad was a pilot, my grandpa was a pilot. I loved airplanes, John knew that. And so, you know, I was working on another project at the time. It was actually about trains. Mm-hmm. It wasn't from the world of cars, it had people and animals in it. But anyways, his epiphany was, you know what? He calls me up and he goes, Clay, I have an idea. I know you're working on the trains movie. He goes, but what do you think about planes? And I'm like, John, I'm in. And the rest was history. I mean, it just sort of started from there. That's how it came about.
Yeah, it's great. At the beginning, when we saw the first footage of the film, it was in D23 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And it had John Cryer attached to the movie. What happened there?
Right. You know, it's just part of movie business. You know, I love John Cryer. Mm-hmm. John Cryer did nothing wrong. It was just sort of as the story, as you know, these things take so long.
Yep.
This was a 4.5 year process. Mm-hmm. And in that process, the character grows, things change, the arcs change, and all kinds of things. And what we were finding is, as the character of Dusty's changed, the tone changed, we needed someone else to sort of help.
The voice changed.
The voice changed.
Yeah.
So that's all that happened, and that's why.
I always wonder when I watch these kind of animated movies, how something like a plane has a life. How do you, in your mind, say, okay, Dusty is going to be like this, he's going to have a higher goal? How does that work?
Well, first of all, it takes an army of talent and lots of great, smart people to help figure that kind of thing out, you know. We landed on Dusty, just the type of airplane he was, because we wanted a classic mm-hmm. underdog story. I love that kind of story. John loves that kind of story. So we knew we had the sort of plane that he was going to be. But then it's just figuring out how many things to add to make his life more difficult and add conflict to make the story mm-hmm. interesting. So my answer to that is it just takes time. And speaking with lots of different individuals to sort of land on something like
that. Yeah. Something great about directors, and even more with animations, that you travel all over the world,
yeah.
you study all the planes. What did you learn from this experience?
I learned, I was fascinated by how many different types of aircraft and pilots there are and how passionate they all are. They all love to fly. You know, there's something magic when you talk to people from all over the world that when they get into a cockpit and they're able to fly, they feel like a different human being. And I came away with that feeling that how special flight is and how magical it
is. What would you tell your friends? What is planes about?
I would say it's about a small town airplane that sort of gets an opportunity of a lifetime. He's built one way, but deep down he feels like he's capable of doing more. And when he gets that opportunity, he goes for it, even though he's afraid. And you'd be surprised by the results that he's able to accomplish.
We Latin Americans are gonna love the Chupacabra. He is great, lo máximo.
Yeah.
And how funny was making that part as a Mexican? Because some of the movies, animations lately, they have like various stereotype
yeah.
the Latino. We have a Latin lover here, who is the Chupacabra. How
right.
did he came into?
Yeah.
The movie?
Well, I love the whole luchador craze.
Mm-hmm.
I love wrestling. I love that idea of the color and the pageantry and everything that goes with that. But you're absolutely correct. You know, we were very cognizant and careful about being respectful to who that character is. Never to make fun of him, to have fun with him
yeah.
and who his personality is. And we're fortunate enough to have people like Art Hernandez on our crew. Art actually was in charge of El Chupacabra. You know, he's a Mexican-American.
Yeah.
And so, and also, you know, it's that kind of thing of, like I said, being respectful, but also embracing just sort of the culture, you know, and the truths of what could come from that.
Yeah, it was great. I wanted to be the Chupacabra. It's a great movie.
Me too.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's nice to meet you.